Gonna be Pluot versus Fudgy. This is a rematch of the grand finals of the first Yulil tournament. So, some history here. Same players, but different characters. Well, actually, let's see here. Pluot plays completely different characters now. He plays Tenshi and Ego, but Fudgy's still sticking with his good old Futo. The relentless rushdown and neutral control. Very hard to deal with. Even though she didn't really... Her combos didn't transfer over well in the patch. Her speed and, basically, all-around neutral game that Futo has pretty much intact. Nice poke out by Pluot, but he drops the combo, unfortunately. Whoa, he was left open because he had to pick up his sword. That was interesting. Oh, pressure extension. Okay, backs off, playing it safe. Oh, but Pluot doesn't get the combo here. Switches to Miko for a chance to help restore his health. Partner Miko did get buffed because she can now use her pull. Okay, good push block by Fudgy. Made by Pluot. Get a knockdown here. Let's see what he gets. Okay. Decent string. Get the chip. Nice combo right there. The thing about Futo's combos is they always look like they're gonna drop. Oh, the tech throw. I did not see that one coming. Fudgy's mix-up, sorry. So many layers. Spell card declaration for Fudgy. Itori and Futo actually has the shortest spell bar in the game, which means they have the easiest last word. So, that's a thing. Fudgy doesn't know his last word confirmed. So. And it's also a very strong reversal. You gotta watch out for it. Here we go. Goes for the spell. Gets the damage. And even though he just used that meter for that spell, his last word's still just a little bit away. Well, in terms of partner meter, probably not, but... Regardless, Pluot's, really in some dire straits. Just really can't get anything done right here. Every time it looks like there's an opening, Fudgy's just all over it. Okay. J&A. Gets the conversion here. Careful. Pluot push blocking for his life, jumps out. Which is the Tenshi. And that should do it. Fudgy takes the first game. Playing a little bit more late back here. If he can find how to win the neutral game at least a few times, he'll definitely win out with superior damage. He see the lasers are a very good adaptation, but here he is in the corner. Oh, nope, drop the combo. Nice push block. Trades. Like the respect on both sides. Nice. Oh, but he's a counter JA right back. Nice 6C. So that's making this a lot closer than it was before. And of course, Futo is pretty challenged when it comes to getting hard knockdowns without using partner tags. Oh, but this is bad. Here's the hard knockdown. Set up! Switches partners here. I think he wanted to partner switch, partner role, but ended up just switching partners. Didn't get punished for it, though. Okay. Not a hard knockdown, but still a good amount of damage. If he was a real Miko player, he would have caped to end that combo. Just saying. What? Chasing him down. Returning 6B. Oh. Oh, it's going to KO. Yes. Okay, Fudgy's at match point and set point as well. So, see if Kula can actually get on the board instead of going down four straight rounds here. Fireballs, 100% limited to key damage. Victory. The pressure doesn't let up even though he swapped his character. Okay, he goes for this declare. Kuat's gonna need to land this if he wants the chance of winning this. At least, I think he needs to land it. But can he find it? Futo's so hard to hit! Oh, an opportunity! Here it comes. He can heal just by waiting. He has a slight health lead, but Fudgy has all the meter here. He can actually declare his fireball. Ooh, oh, that's a huge drop for Fudgy, for Fluwat. He's gonna take this damage, and that might not quite KO, but what could have been if he landed it? Just Miko here. Basically his last chance. His partner breaks, it's over. Look at the time. Fudgy only needs to run away right now. What are you going in? And that should do it. Or not. But! Oh, I just wake up 6 a.m. 6 a.m. That's it. Fudgy with the 2-0.